We got a new update on the path and growing strength of the storm. The track of the powerful Category 4 hurricane now shifting east as it intensifies, putting millions more Americans in its path. The potential strike zone has now widened to include Georgia and the Carolinas, causing the governor of South Carolina to declare a state of emergency to prepare for the storm. Meteorologist Chad Myers is in the CNN Weather Center. Chad, what's it doing?
Fred, what it's doing right now, it's still 150. We did not get to that Category 5 everyone was anticipating at 2 p.m. Still Category 4, that's the good news. 150 miles per hour right now, and you need to be about 157 to get to Cat 5. So I can't really tell the difference between 150 and 157. If you can, so better for you. 150 miles per hour, but the gusts are 185. We know there are gusts out there because there is a hunter out there, a Hurricane Hunter aircraft flying through the eye. For me, this is a no thank you. They found a wind gust to 166. Now you say, now why isn't it now a Cat 5 if it's 166? Because that's a gust that is not sustained. We have to wait for sustained to get above 157 to get to 5. And hopefully it never does that, because that's not even the forecast. But it is forecast now to slow down on the way to Florida, as we expected, but make that turn not along the spine of Florida, but offshore. That's the great news, because if we only get waves and a little bit of wind with this, we still will get tremendous flooding, but we're not going to get the wind damage. We're not going to get wind damage of 150 mile per hour wind like we saw literally in Homestead, Florida after Andrew. Huge waves coming here, that big yellow or red ball that you saw right there, 40 foot waves offshore. Some of them will make it over to the barrier islands. Some of it will make it over, you know, the reefs that are offshore, but most of those will be knocked down before you get there. But there will be an awful lot of erosion along the East Coast. I've moved the map ahead to 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon to show you where the storm will be. Everything that's white in here, all those winds are over 100. They're all offshore, but they're not offshore for the Bahamas. Bahamas will take a direct hit from this, especially the northern part, Grand Bahama Island, and then eventually that'll turn to the north. But all of this onshore flow here will create high tides way above where we were going to be. Even with the king tide, we could see even a swell of 5 to 7 feet in those back bays, and that's not even storm surge as the storm crashes onshore, because it isn't going to crash onshore, at least for now. There will even be some surge on the west side of the storm as you push water into Florida Bay. So all of you on the west side of Florida, you watch for those water levels to be rising as well. The approach of the weather, really 8 o'clock on Sunday night, we'll get our first taste of any type of tropical storm force winds, and that will be across parts of South Florida, because that's where it's going to be closest. An ugly looking eye here. This thing is just done everything it needs to do to get stronger and stronger, and there's nothing in the way except for that hopeful turn.
Oh, Fred, yes.
Sometimes they turn. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they're stubborn. Let's hope this one isn't stubborn.
Yeah, we're hoping for that U-turn. All right. Thank you so much. And then, you know, losing steam, not threatening anybody else out there.
There are certain things that you need more than others, and you don't always know exactly what that is. Perhaps unless you've been through something like this.
Yeah, Allison, how about it? What should people be stocking up on?
Right, so you always think of the obvious. You need flashlights, you need a weather radio, you need water. The question is, what else do you need and how much of them? Water is an obvious, but do you know how much you need? Here's the general rule of thumb, 1 gallon per person per day. So let's say you have a family of five. You're going to need 5 gallons per day that you end up having to ride out the storm. And keep in mind, you usually don't use power for just an hour or two. In these instances, it's likely going to be several days. Also, we talk about flashlights, things like that, but don't forget the extra batteries to go with it. Also, great things to have, portable chargers. These are great for your cell phones, tablets, computers, things like that, to keep them charged throughout the day. Also, any important paperwork, insurance information, passports, even your cash, keep it in a plastic bag so that if you do get flooding, it's not going to get wet or get ruined. Another thing, Victor and Christy, too, take an inventory of what's in your house. This will make it so much easier if you have to file an insurance claim to know what is in your house and what is missing. Another thing, take pictures. Take pictures of every single room, because you may not always remember everything that you have in there if it does get damaged or get ruined. One other thing, top three items. You're obviously going to need things to drink and things to eat. Here's the thing. Walmart runs analytics on this for years. The top three items that end up selling out in the days leading up to hurricanes, beer, water, and Pop-Tarts. Specifically, the strawberry flavor is 7 times more likely to sell out than the other flavor. So get your supply of your Pop-Tarts on the front end.
What do you want to say?
I don't want to say anything at all. But I mean, if I'm picking Pop-Tarts, we go with the frosted instead of the unfrosted. I feel like that's a natural choice.
Yeah, don't embarrass yourself by getting unfrosted ones.
All right, Allison Chinchara, thanks so much.
Thanks, Allison.